And now to that horrific attack at a high school in Florida. 17 killed, more than a dozen injured. Florida Governor Rick Scott calling it pure evil.
Yeah, 19-year-old Nicholas Cruz was taken into custody shortly after the attack. Overnight, investigators searched for more evidence at the school.
Ellery McArdle joining us now with the latest on this investigation. Ellery?
Yeah, guys, there's so much more to learn yet today. Authorities are going through Cruz's social media posts after reports he has very disturbing material online. Investigators still haven't released a motive behind the attack. And right now we have new video to show you this morning. We just got this in. It shows Cruz being led into the Broward County Jail yet this morning. He was arrested yesterday about a mile from Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School. The Broward County Sheriff's Office believes Cruz fired the shots at the school with a semi-automatic rifle after pulling an alarm, releasing students from their classes. The school's superintendent says Cruz was recently expelled for disciplinary reasons. His mother recently died, and he had been living with a family without any issues or concerns. But students paint a grim picture of Cruz, saying he was a loner and preoccupied with guns.
When I was in the vocational school, the alternative school, he went ahead and showed me all his layout of guns and said that how he used to just shoot them around for fun.
All of those killed in the attack have been identified, but no names have been officially released. However, the school's football program tweeted that its assistant football coach died while shielding students from the gunfire. Tim.
Thank you, Ellery. Lawmakers are finding themselves in an all too familiar position after this latest school shooting, many expressing horror but little else, while others are demanding change to the country's gun laws. Melissa Colorado joins us now with more on that. Melissa.
Good morning. While some Democrats were quick to demand action, Republicans generally avoided calling for legislative change, at least in the immediate aftermath. President Trump tweeted this: "My prayers and condolences to the families of the victims of the terrible Florida shooting. No child, teacher, or anyone else should ever feel unsafe in an American school." Senator Marco Rubio of Florida tweeted this: "In days ahead, will become increasingly evident that killer in today's Florida school shooting gave plenty of indications of what was to come." Florida Governor Rick Scott said yesterday that the school shooting in South Florida was absolutely pure evil and that there's a time to continue having conversations about mental health and gun control.
"I'm sure every parent's doing the same thing. Is my child going to a safe school? Is it safe where they're going? And I know our law enforcement is going to continue to do everything they can to keep every child in our state safe. And we're going to continue to figure out how we learn from this."
President Trump also tweeted that he spoke to Governor Rick Scott and that they are working closely with law enforcement. Alicia.
All right, Melissa, thank you. In other news this morning, Governor Dayton pitched a new tax on opioids as part of the plan to fight the overdose epidemic. He's calling it a stewardship fee, one penny per pill, to help offset the cost of treatment and prevention of opioid addictions. Part of that money would go to pay for emergency antidotes such as Narcan, because many first responders have exhausted their supplies. Among the supporters are state lawmakers who've lost adult children to heroin addictions that began with prescription painkillers.
"That's 43,000 people in the country last year died of this opioid epidemic. Now, if I was standing here 10 years ago and would have said those numbers, I would have laughed, because I would have never dreamt we would ever, as a country, would have allowed it to get this bad."
In 2016, 395 Minnesotans died of opioid overdoses, an 18% jump over the previous year. The stats for 2017 aren't available yet.
A priest in the St. Cloud Diocese has been charged with criminal sexual conduct for an inappropriate relationship with a woman dating back to 2013. Father Anthony Joseph Ulrich is charged with having sex with the woman who came to him for spiritual guidance. The woman alleges she sought help and confessed to Ulrich that she was the victim of sexual assault. Minnesota law prohibits a member of the clergy from engaging in a relationship under such circumstances. Ulrich was arrested Tuesday and has been suspended as a priest by the diocese.
A man accused of ripping off dozens of local businesses with a fundraising scam didn't stop after Care Lovin' exposed him. Authorities say he just changed his name. Mike Gerken, who runs the business Moms and Dads for Kids, is now facing criminal charges in Iowa, where authorities there say he duped businesses out of more than $11,000 using the name Bob Anderson. Here in Minnesota, he's charged with taking money from a Rogers chiropractor. Eric Knutson said Gerken used that same alias, even signing a contract as Bob Anderson. But once he had gotten $790 from Knutson,
We could not reach him via phone. It seemed like he had blocked that number. We found your guys' news stories and realized that this was a scam.
Hey, Mike, what happened?
And we tried to talk to Mike Gerken after a recent court hearing, but you see there, he took off. After our stories, the attorney general, she sued him on behalf of more than 40 small businesses.
Sorry, what happened?
Well, Team USA Hockey dealing with some losses on the ice yesterday, unfortunately.
Well, the men, they dropped their Olympic opener 3-2 to Slovenia yesterday. A loss made even more bitter because Team USA actually jumped out to a 2-0 lead. Team USA gave up two goals late in the game, allowing it to go to overtime, where it didn't take long for this one to get away. The Americans give up the game winner in less than a minute in the OT. 3-2, Slovenia wins in overtime. Team USA, not much time to bounce back. They play Slovakia tomorrow morning.
A loss for the women as well against rival Canada. Dave Schwartz was at the match and he spoke to the team afterwards.
Well, the heavyweight fight that everyone had been waiting for lives up to its billing. Team USA, though, losing to Team Canada in women's hockey 2-1. USA only able to score one goal. Kendall Coyne does that in the third period. But Genevieve Lacasse for Team Canada absolutely shuts things down. This game was tough, it was tight, and it was very physical. And in the end, it's a bit of a disappointment for Team USA to lose to their rival.
Yeah, I mean, I thought we had a pretty good game overall. We got a lot of shots, but we got to find a way to bury more of them.
Whenever we play Canada, you can expect each team's 100% and a very intense game. So, yeah.
You know, everyone wants to win. We certainly want to win. We want to put that puck in the net, and when it's sitting there, we're going to go after it. So it's pretty indicative of these two teams.
At the end of the day, you can't worry about scoring goals. You got to do the little things right day in and day out, which we did. We're three games into this tournament, and I believe we've outshot our teams 2-1 each game.
Though disappointing, the loss doesn't do any real harm for Team USA as they are still moving on to the semifinals. In South Korea, Dave Schwartz, Care 11 News.
Well, now on to curling. It was a game of big ends, but in the end, the USA comeback attempt came up just short in a 9-10 loss to Italy in the men's curling tournament. The game in all had five ends in which two or more points were scored. USA now has one win, one loss, and a matchup tomorrow against Sweden. Something that is winning the Olympics, curler Matt Hamilton's mustache. Last week, there was a tweet going around comparing Matt to Mario from the Nintendo game. Now they're adding in another Wisconsinite with a mustache, Packers quarterback Aaron Rodgers as Luigi. Chris Hockey of KFAN also contributed to the facial hair fest, even getting compliments from the king of the mustache, Hamilton. That's a pretty good stash.
That is a pretty good soup strainer, yeah. Tonight's Olympic coverage begins with the Olympic Zone at 6:30. Then it's the start of men's figure skating live. Also, women's snowboard cross, men's skeleton finals, and more skiing coverage all coming up your way tonight in primetime. Still to come right here, Marvel's Black Panther has already smashed pre-sale records.
This film reminds us what's great about ourselves.
A look at the movie with an all-star cast and a superpowered message generations of fans have waited to see.
I plan to see that tomorrow. I'm excited for that. We're looking forward to temperatures today that are going to make a little bit of a drop. We're in the 20s and 30s right now, mid-30s this afternoon. But look at what happens up north. That cold air starts to move in into the evening. We'll have more on that coming up.